So I've been to a party not so long ago. That day, I came to realize that since high school, I became more comfortable meeting and talking to people. I still remember the time that I was terrified just by the thought of meeting someone. And having to maintain a conversation was dreadful. But that night, I was actually not too awkward. This may be because I held back on my awkward jokes. But I felt like I've evolved from a Charmander to a Charizard. And I think that there were a few books that really helped me. But most importantly, believing that social skills is learnable and actually go out there and practice was a cornerstone. And for this video, I'm going to use the book How to Talk to Anyone by Leil Lowndes as a reference. So there are actually three things that really helped me improve my interaction and build meaningful rapport. And the first one is first impression. Let's be honest, people make an idea of who we are within a few seconds of seeing us. Even before we can say a word, like it or not, we get judged and we judge people. So the next time you meet someone, remember this. Try to walk like this. Not exactly, but be sure to walk straight. Pretend that you're hanging by your teeth, literally. When you approach a person, slowly pivot your body to face the person. This will help you build a sense of trust and signals your interest towards them. And then, as you walk or approach them, never lose eye contact. And just before saying a word, slip a little smile, then you can start the conversation. If you do this right, this is going to help you appear friendlier. Because being social is really about knowing how to approach others and being approachable. You don't have to trust me, just try it for yourself. If you just walk straight, improve your eye contact, and smile just a little more, I'm sure you will nail most of your first impression in a social environment. Then there are small talks. I was not a big believer of small talks, but it really is a mean to an end. We must do it to build rapport with people, and it's also the entry point for a deeper conversation. After all, life would be pretty weird without small talks. Imagine, I go up to you and say, without notice, "My name is John, I live in Montreal, Canada. I want to know, where do you stand on climate change? Explain yourself and let's be friends." Look, let's not creep out people, even though I enjoy that. If you follow these tips, small talk will come more naturally, and maybe it will help you forget that you're doing some small talks. So first, don't worry too much about how you start the conversation. It says that what people think of you has little to do with the first few words you say. So just keep a positive attitude and pretend that you're talking to an old friend. And a classic starter is using a statement followed by a question. For example, "Hey, nice dress, where did you get it? This room has beautiful decoration, how do you know the Smith? I really like this coffee shop, is there somebody sitting next to you?" Wow, I sound so cool, but in reality, I have to admit that I'm still a little bit nervous, but at least now I can contain myself. Once the conversation starts flowing, the second trick is to ask open-ended questions. Like, "Tell me a little bit about where you're from. What do you think about the election? What do you do as a hobby?" The trick here is to ask questions, but also to participate in them. We don't want to make it seem like an interrogation, so make sure to give information about yourself little by little. Next, be a word detective. Keep a close attention to what the person is talking about. Because small talk is only a way of finding common ground to expand to more meaningful conversation. For example, the person might be talking about his last trip and how he stayed on a boat to explore the coral reef. You then realize he really enjoys scuba diving, which is also a passion of yours. The third component is body language. As first impression, during the conversation, we want to make sure to stay tuned to our body language. So make sure that your eye contact is on point and your whole body is facing them during the conversation. Then, you can add this synchronizing trick. This involves that you pay attention to their tone of voice, their mood, their gesture, and simply try to mimic some of them. I know, it may sound creepy, and I said, I was all about being creepy. But if you don't mirror their every move and do it with the intent of building rapport, this will be very effective. Next, all along the conversation, try to not fidget. Our goal is to give our full attention to the person without being distracted by the environment or by our own thoughts. Don't think about what to say next. Simply stay still and listen carefully. That's it. Being social is as any other skill. You simply need practice. And in further videos, I might go in more detail about first impression, small talks, and body language. So I hope you like this one and make sure to subscribe right here. And until next time, I hope I brought you one step closer to your brighter self.